For from the rising of the sun, even to the going down, my name is great among the Gentiles. And in every place there is sacrifice, and there is offered to my name a clean oblation. For my name is great among the Gentiles, saith the Lord of hosts.
On this and the two following days, the church anticipates the night office. She celebrates it on the previous evening of each day, and this in order that the faithful may be present at it. The matins and lauds of Maundy Thursday are, therefore, said this afternoon. The faithful should make every effort to assist at this solemn office, seeing it is on their account that the church has changed her usual hours. As to the merit there is in joining in it, there can be no doubt, but that it is to be preferred to any private devotions, the surest means for obtaining favors from God and winning him to our requests is to approach him through the church. And as regards the feelings of devotion wherewith we ought to celebrate the mysteries of these three great days, the offices of the church are, ordinarily speaking, a surer and richer source than the exercises of piety composed by men. The soul that feeds on the words and ceremonies of the Holy Church will be all the more disposed to profit by the private devotions she practices at home. The prayer of the church will thus become the basis whereon is built the edifice of Christian piety during these glorious anniversaries of our redemption. And we shall be imitating our forefathers who lived in the ages of faith, and who were such admirable Christians, because they lived the life of the church by means of the sacred liturgy. Venerable Pontiff, the acceptable time has come, the day of God's mercy and of man's salvation, when death was destroyed and eternal life began. This is the time when in the vineyard of the Lord of Sabbath, new plants are to be set, and the detestableness of the old growth is to be pruned away. For though there be no period of time which is not rich in the goodness and mercy of God, yet now indulgence produces a more abundant remission of sins, and grace yields a more plentiful number of the regenerated. Those that are regenerated add to our ranks, those that return increase our numbers. There is a laver of water, there is a laver of tears. From the one there is joy because of the admittance that these thy suppliant servants, after having fallen into sundry kinds of sins, by the neglect of the divine commandments and the transgression of the moral law, humbled and prostrate, cry out to the Lord in these words of the prophet, "We have sinned, we have done unjustly, we have committed iniquity. Have mercy on us, O Lord. It has not been in vain that they have heard the words of the gospel. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. As it is written, they have eaten the bread of sorrow. They have watered their couch with tears. They have afflicted their hearts with mourning, and their bodies with fasting, that thus they might recover the health of soul which they had lost. The grace of penance, therefore, is one, but it profits each one that receives it, and gives help to all in common. Vexilla regis prodeunt, fulcet crucis mysterium, qua vita mortem perturit, et morte vitam proturit. The standard of our King comes forth. The mystery of the cross shines upon us, that cross on which life suffered death, and by his death gave life. Quae fulnerata lance, mucrone diro crimino, ut nosa varet sordibus, manavit unda et sanguine. He was pierced with the cruel spear, that by the water and the blood which flowed from the wound, he might cleanse us from sin. Impleta sunt quae concinit, David fideli calmine, dicendo nationibus, regnavit aligno Deus. Here on the cross was fulfilled the prophecy foretold in David's truthful words, God hath reigned from the tree. It is truly meet and right to proclaim with all our heart and all the affection of our mind, and with the ministry of our voices, the invisible God, the Father Almighty, and his only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who repaid for us to his eternal Father the debt of Adam, and by the merciful shedding of his blood, cancelled the debt incurred by original sin. For this is the Paschal festival, in which that true Lamb is slain, with whose blood the doorposts of the faithful are consecrated. This is the night in which thou didst formerly cause our forefathers, the children of Israel, when brought out of Egypt, to pass through the Red Sea with dry foot. This, therefore, is the night which dissipated the darkness of sinners by the light of the pillar. This is the night which at this time throughout the world restores to grace and unites in sanctity those that believe in Christ and are separated from the vices of the world and the darkness of sinners. This is the night in which, destroying the chains of death, Christ arose victorious from the grave.